Good day, everyone. I'm Solomon Elijah. So today we're going to be looking at past question in English. We're going to be looking at 2010 Y objective questions. One thing you must take note of is that whenever you are attempting question, it is important that you understand the instruction, as instruction is part of examination. Now let's take a look at this. In each of the following sentences, there is one underlined word and one gap. From the list of the words letter A to D, choose the one word that is most nearly opposite in meaning to the underlying word and that will at the same time correctly fill the gap in the sentence. Now, what we're actually looking at here is antonyms. We want to look at the opposite. Now, you must take note that whenever you are doing this, you must read the sentence and understand that there is what we call contextual meaning. Let's take a look at this. Number one, they had some profit from a fish business made Mrs. Umba stop complaining about her husband's dash salary. A, ugly. B, meager. C, modest. And D, lonely. Now looking at the option provided, if you are to go for the first one, which is ugly, it has no relation with the word handsome prophet. So that is not an option at all. Let's look at B. But before we look at B, let's look at C. Modest. You notice that handsome prophet and modest, they are not in any way related. Now, the last one, D, which is lonely. Now, lonely is not related with handsome prophet. Then that will leave us with an option B, which is mega. Yes, that is the answer. The answer is mega. Now, when you talk about mega, it's something that is not too big, minute. Let's look at the second question. The second question is, Chief Osa prefers fame in the village to dash in the city. A, neglect. B, ignorance. C, poverty. And D, obscurity. Now let's look at this. The underlying word there is fame. So we are looking at the opposite of fame. Now, according to the contextual meaning of fame, looking at the opposite, you won't go for neglect. Why? Neglect doesn't fit in that context. Ignorance? No, ignorance is not the answer. We are talking about fame. So the opposite of fame can never be ignorance. Now let's look at the option C, poverty. Fame, the opposite, poverty. No, that is incorrect as well. All right, let's look at the last option D, obscurity. Yes, that is correct. That is the right answer. Mind you, I told you, there are some words that You don't judge them by the way the dictionary meaning. You need to understand how the word function in the sentence before you can actually provide the antonym for such word. All right. Next. Third, the media houses should employ both novice and dash journalist. A. Apprentice. B. Provisional. C. Newcomer. D. Veteran. The underlying word here is novice, so we want to look at the word that is the opposite of novice, considering the context of where the word novice is being used. If you go for A, apprentice, it is not a register of journalism. So you'll be wrong by going for A. B is also wrong. C, newcomer, no, is wrong. So the best option and the correct option there is D. Yes, veteran. That is the answer. Yes. Let's look at the next question. Number four. Why the registrar considers the matter insignificant? His deputy sees it as dash. Option A, minute. Option B, crucial. Option C, compulsory. Option D, marvelous. Now, let's consider the words. The word we're actually looking for, the opposite, is insignificant. Insignificant. When you say something is insignificant, it means that person is less important. It means that thing or that person is less important. But in the case here, we're talking about the matter. So when you say the matter, why the registrar consider the matter insignificant, is deputy to see it as dash. So let's look at the first one. Minute. No, minute is not the right answer. Minute and insignificant are synonymous. Let's look at B, crucial. Yes, that is the answer. Crucial. Yes, that is the answer. All right, let's consider the next question. Question five. It pays to be firm rather than dash in a case like this. Option A, flexible. Option B, frank. Option C, irresponsible. Option D, careless. Now let's consider the word firm. The opposite of firm. When you say something is firm, it means it is rigid. Now, just like I said, you need to consider the contextual meaning or the premise at which the word is being used. Now, the word we're actually looking for, the opposite, is firm. The answer is flexible. The answer is flexible. Now let's look at the next one. Six. Usually, Joseph is articulate in his speech, but today sounds dash. A. Claire. B. Target. C. Timid. D. Incoherent. Now, when you say Joseph is articulate, it means he speaks fluently. Yes, so the first one is clear. So when you say someone speaks fluently, it means the person speaks clearly. So the answer is not A. It's not also B. It's not also C. The answer is incoherent. When you say someone is speaking incoherently, it means that the words are not clear. Or better still, there is no coordination in the person's speech. All right, let's consider the next one. Yes. The next one. Seven. The man's first wife is loyal, while second is dash. A. Unfaithful. B. Unkind. C. Selfish. D. Hostile. Now look at this carefully. The underlying word here is loyal. The underlying word here is loyal. So we are looking for the opposite. Now, if you say someone is, let's start from option D, hostile, that there is no relationship between loyal and hostile. There is no relationship. Because when you talk about loyal, it has to do with someone that is faithful. Yes, you see. So selfish is not in any way related. It's not even the opposite. So the option that is correct is A, unfaithful. Yes. Mind you, I told you that it is imperative that you understand the instruction before you attempt your answer. Let's consider the next one. Yeah, the answer is unfaithful. Let's consider the next one. Eight. Rather than convict him, the impartial judge dashed him. A. Blamed. B. Dismissed. C. Uphead. D. Acquitted. Now, you need to understand the environment in which this word is being used. And that was the reason I said you need to know the context of which the word that we're considering is convinced. Okay, so the context in which this is being used, the opposite of this word is acquitted. Yes, that is the answer, acquitted. Acquitted is the answer. Yeah, that is the answer, acquitted. All right. Let's move on to the next question. Nine. Instead of reconciling her parents, Rosalind worked hard at dash them. Now, you look at the word reconciling. Now, if you notice, reconciling is the word here. Reconciling, the opposite of reconciling, okay? It cannot be dividing. Now, just like I said before now, dividing cannot actually replace reconciling as the opposite word. No. Do you know why? It doesn't fit in that context. Destroying is not an option. So we have C or D. Now let's look at C. Now if we look at C, separating, in a relationship, that word is actually meaningful. So the opposite of reconciling, that is, instead of reconciling her parents, Rosalind worked hard at separating them. So that is the answer. The answer is separating. Yes, that's the answer. All right, so let's take a look at the next question. We thought that Uncle Sam's health has improved, but it had rather dash. A, persisted. B, deteriorated. C, deepened. D, decreased. Now, the first word there, which is persisted, is not the right answer. But before we actually look at that, let's look at the word that has been underlined. The underlying word here is improved. Improved. Now let's look at the opposite of improved in this context. It can be persistent. B, deteriorated. Yes, that is the answer. The word deteriorated means when something is getting worse. Yes, when something is getting worse. So, deteriorated fit that gap. So, the word deteriorated, it actually means when something is getting worse. Now, let's consider the next question. Now, the answer is deteriorated. Yes, we have come to the end of the section one. Let's move to the next section. Just like I said, it is important that you read the instruction and understand it. From the words lettered A to D, choose the word that best completes each of the following sentences. Eleven. One very important aspect of human relationship is dash trust. A, communal. B, individual. C, mutual. D, personal. The right answer is mutual. Yes, that is the correct answer. So the question is why? Mutual trust actually means a reciprocating trust. So the word that fits in is mutual trust, not individual and not personal. Since we are talking about human relationship, okay? Let's move on to the next one. Yes, 12. The two tasks were performed dash and we were able to finish early. The two tasks were performed dash and we were able to finish early. A, alternatively. B, simultaneously. C, consecutively. D, separately. Now, you are able to finish the task, the two tasks. You know, when you put something side by side, when you juxtapose something, and you are, as you're working with this, you're working with this, you're working with this, you're working with this, that is simultaneously. So simultaneously is a word that actually fit in the gap. Yes, that's the answer, simultaneously. 13. The committee is charged with finding dash solution to the crisis. Now let's look at option A. Lengthy. Lengthy. That doesn't actually suit the gap. It is not suitable. So let's look at option B, current. A current solution? No, that is wrong. It can be strong also. The right word there is lasting. And I will say this, that this section, you need to know that there is a way you can figure out the answer. And that is if you understand how words are often used together. And we are talking about collocation. Collocation is how words are often used together. So if you are so conversant with your book, you know, you've been reading newspaper and all, you will notice that lasting solution, you know, lasting collocate with solution, lasting solution, not lengthy. Okay, so the answer is lasting solution. All right. Yes, 14. We are worried by the dash that exists between the two factors of the party. We are worried by the dash that exists between the two factions of the party. Option A, distraction. B, commotion. C, confusion. D, rivalry. Yes. Now, just like I said, look at the word distraction. Distraction doesn't sit. It cannot sit on that space. You can't say we are worried by the distraction that exists. No, no. Now, when you have two parties, you know, when you have two parties, when you're talking about two parties, you know, they have, you know, the same ambition, they have the same goal, but on a different platform. So what happens? There's going to be rivalry. So the best option or the correct option is D, rivalry. Rivalry. So that is the right option. So let's look at the answer. Yes, rivalry. That is correct. All right. So 15. Our teacher was not speaking dash when he said that the boss was under a cloud. Let's look at option one, literally. Option A, literally. Option B, simply. Option C, frankly. Option D, directly. All right. The first one, literally. It means a dictionary word. A word that you can find the meaning in dictionary. Yes. It means it has a denotative meaning. When you say literally, it means the same word you've used, for example, when you say, when you use the word like go. Now, the literal meaning of go is to leave, and that is the dictionary meaning. So option A, literally. Option B, simply. Option C, frankly. And option D, directly. The answer is literally. Do you know why? Our teacher was not speaking literally when he said that the boss was under a cloud. So meaning that the teacher was not speaking literally, rather the teacher used a figurative expression. You know, when you say someone is under a cloud, when you say someone is under a cloud, it means that person is under an influence. Yes, so let's look at the answer. The answer is A, literally. Yes, that is the answer, literally. All right, let's consider the next question. 16. The signature on the document lacked dash, so it was rejected. A, clarity. B, authenticity. C, formality. D, simplicity. Now let's start with the first option, clarity. Clarity, you know, the main thing we're talking about here is the signature, okay? So what is the function of a signature on a document? That's a question you need to ask yourself. Is not for clarity? Yes, you can say that it's for formality, but it doesn't really work in this context. Simplicity? No. The right answer is authenticity. That is the right answer. Let's check it out. Yes, that is it. All right, moving on. Same thing. Everyone could tell that Binta was happy from the dash on her face. A, picture. B, appearance. C, expression. D. Everyone could tell that Binta was happy for Dash on her face. A. Picture. B. Appearance. C. Expression. D. Sight. Now let's look at picture. You can't have picture, you can't say that everyone could tell that Binta was happy from the picture on her face. No. It can be appearance. The correct answer is expression. Let's check it out. Yes, expression. That is the correct answer. Now, 18. His novel was dashed by his visits to the prison. A. Inspired. B. Generated. C. Conceived. D. Revealed. His novel was dashed by his visits to the prison. The right answer is inspired. His novel was inspired by his visit to the prison. All right, let's look at the next one. Yes, that's the answer, inspired, yes. All right, number 19. As a result of the power cut, the production at the paint factory came to a dash. A. Hold up. B. Blocking. C. Standstill. D. Suspense. All right. So let's look at what we're looking at here is production at the factory, you know, paint factory. So the word or the register that is suitable to fill that gap is not holder. No, it can't. So the right word is standstill. That's the word, standstill. Yes, that is it. Question 20. Several dash were passed at the meeting. A. Memoranda. B. Decisions. C. Resolutions. D. Actions. Now let's start from the first one, which is A. Memoranda. Okay, you will agree with me that the plural of memorandum is memoranda. So it can't be memoranda. Why? Because they are already in the meeting. B is not an option. Yes. So the correct answer is C, resolutions. Resolutions. That is the correct answer. All right, so let's look at the next. Yes, let's look at the next section, that is section 3. After each of the following sentences, a list of possible interpretations is given. Choose the interpretation that you consider most appropriate for each sentence. All right. 21. James and Harry were at Dagger's Draw when I knew them. Let's consider the word Dagger's Draw. Okay? Underline the word Dagger's Draw. Option A, we're always angry with each other. Option B, always wore daggers. Option C, we're good at drawing daggers. Option D, we're fighting everybody. Now let's consider the first one. When you say that the first option, which is option A, we're always angry with each other. That is the correct option. Do you know why? When you say that someone is at daggers drawn, it actually means that the person, okay, with the other person has used in this contest. It means that they are always quarreling with each other. Yes, that's the meaning. Okay? Yes, we're always angry with each other. 22. My book has become dog hair through use. This means A, the corner of the pages of my book are crumpled. B, my book is designed like dog ears. C, my book is torn. D, my book is indispensable. Let's check out the answer. Yes, the answer is A. The corner of the pages of my book are crumpled. Yes. Twenty-three. Most does not believe that there is poverty in Africa. Is a dyed-in-the-wool capitalist. This means that A, kind capitalist. B, a thoughtful capitalist. C, an old capitalist. D, an unbending capitalist. Now, the word that we are considering is dyed in the wool capitalist. And the best option that is suitable for that phrase is an unbending capitalist. So the answer is D. Yes. An unbending capitalist. Yeah. 24. Whenever my cousin comes to realize that I'm telling the truth, she will eat humble pie. This means that A, respects me. B, hates herself. C, apologize. D, be ashamed. Now, the phrase we're actually considering is eat humble pie. Okay, so the right option is option C, apologize. When you say someone eats humble pie, it means the person has been humiliated. Means the person has been forced to submission. Thereafter, the person will apologize. So the answer is not respect me. No, the answer is apologize. Twenty-five. I had a dinner with Tony and Nick, and they talked shop the whole time. This means that they talk A, about buying things from the shop, B, about their jobs, C, all the time, D, about taking me to the shop. All right, let's look at the phrase. Or let's look at the clause. Yes, it's actually clause. They talk shop the whole time. Yes, that's the clause. Okay, let's look at it. And it's an idiom. So when you say that they talk shop all the whole time, it means that they talk about the businesses or the jobs. They discuss extensively about what they do. So which option do you think is the right one? Is it A, B, C, or D? The option that is right is B. Yes, they talk about their jobs. His decision to reconcile with his former agent paid off. This means that the reconciliation dash. Yes, when you say something pays off, it actually means that it yielded positive result. Yes. So the right answer is option A, yielded positive result. Yes, yielded positive result. Now I need to say this at this point, that always try to read the instruction and try to understand, especially this section 3. It is very important that you understand what you are reading before you actually choose your answer, so that you'll be able to get it right. Now let's look at 27. The beauty of Bibi's garden shows that she has green fingers. This means that Bibi A, always paints her fingers green, B, is good at growing plants, C, turns everything she touches to green, D, likes keeping green objects. Now, the beauty of being based garden, you'll notice that garden is being used there. Okay, shows that she has green fingers. Now, this is euphemism. Okay, euphemism is actually expressing unpleasant situation in a pleasant way. Alright, but you will agree with me that when you say that the beauty of Bingley's garden shows that she has green fingers, you know, this is actually talking about green, you know, it's a representation of vegetation, is a representation of plants, green fingers. Okay, let's look at the option. The right option is B, is good at growing plants. Yes, that is it. All right, let's consider 28. I visited you, but for my father's illness help. This means that my dash. Okay, I would have visited you, but for my father's ill health. This means that dash. A. Father's ill health would have made me to visit you. B. Father's ill health prevented me from visiting you. C. Father's threatened to fall ill if I visited you. D. Father did not fall ill, so I couldn't visit you. Now, looking at this question, there is a clause there. There is contraction. Okay? You notice that there is contraction. Like, you have, I would have visited you, but for my father's ill health. So, which means that I would have loved to visit you, but I couldn't visit you because my father was indisposed. Another word for ill health. Okay, let's look at the option. Option A, no. Option B, yes. My father's illness prevented me from visiting you. That is the correct answer. Yes. 29. Her husband's death has forced her to tighten her belt. Husband that has forced her to tighten her belt. This means that A, become more economical. B, adjust her belt. C, become more aggressive. D, become very rigid. Oh, I beg your pardon. Become very greedy. So now let's see, this question is actually talking about something that happened to the husband. Okay, her husband's death has forced her to tighten her belt. What that means is that there is no source of income. Probably the husband used to be the person that provides for the family. So for her to actually schedule, she needs to be more economical. Now the word economical, it actually means when you try to manage something very well. So the option is, the right option is A. The right option is A. Yes. 30. Some candidates take examination in their strides. This means that they, okay, let's look at option A. Prepare hard for exam. Prepare hard for them. B. Do not worry about them. C. Find them insurmountable. D. Are familiar with them. Okay, so the question is, some candidates take examination in their strides. Let's look out for the meaning. Yes, the answer is do not worry about them. Okay, in the strides actually means when you careless about something, when you don't really bother about something, okay? So this is where we're going to stop here today, as we're going to continue in our next class. Thank you.